Hi, gents. Following our exploration of the first four tasks on the canvas page, the introduction to Mod A and dystopian fiction, it's important now that you guys continue to develop your research into dystopian fiction first and foremost, but then obviously a proper branch as dystopian fiction. Okay, there's some excellent resources here that I want you guys to go through into your own. In your own time, sort of look at some sort of key notes that you can sort of comprehend and understand, so that if someone wants to talk to you about dystopian fiction, can you respond to them in a concerted and cohesive manner for a couple of minutes? You know, what I mean by that is that you can become an expert in dystopian fiction. To a level that we would expect from the opening weeks of this course. Okay, so I would like you to look at how you can undertake further reading here on dystopian fiction. Okay, if you just go into this first one here, it's quite a concise resource that sort of tells you what a utopia dystopia is, but even in the characteristics of a dystopian society, like, we know that topic range is dystopian. How do we know that? Okay, do we know that that we have that sort of sense of control over the citizens in society? Okay, you have Alex who acts out and does what he wants because he has free will. But he has that sense that there is no sort of sense of him exploring the alternative, as in doing what society expects him to do, because he doesn't feel it alive by just abiding by the rules. So whilst these are characteristics of a dystopian society, they are not necessarily the be-all and end-all list of what we can expect to see in every single dystopian text. Okay? We do have types of dystopian controls here. Obviously corporate control, Minority Report, Running Man, classic Arnold Schwarzenegger, fantastic film. If you get a chance, have a look at it, even just for the special effects and the acting. Then you have also Brazil. You all know The Matrix, I'm sure, whether you've watched it or not. It wouldn't be a bad idea to engage in that exploration for yourself. The Terminator, the original one, obviously, and Europa. These are just some that you could even take into your view this evening. Okay. Now, if we look at the other sort of resources that are available here, we have some critical articles on the roots of dystopia and what it is that dystopia is. For example, one man's dystopia could be another man's utopia. Okay, and you will find that there are some references to text that you know here. Okay, 1984, Fahrenheit 451. Because these are the sort of definitions of dystopian literature in the novel form. And for me, three classics that you can read and read on numerous occasions. This text here, The Lottery by Shirley Jackson, I highly recommend you guys read that as well, because it's, I suppose, it is confronting and disturbing the content of that. I suppose of that text, and indeed it was actually made into a short film. That if you want, I can try and source that for you guys as well. Because it's so important that we have an idea about what dystopian fiction is, and of course then fear of dystopia. Okay? I think that we have some fantastic sort of elements here that you can, you know, read through in your own time, because this is what being an advanced English student is all about. It's about you going beyond just the texts that you read, okay? Because you need to be able to sort of develop your critical thinking about said texts, okay? So I would, right now, look through those three articles for task five, and then once you get through all that, start to look at task six. Take some notes and then find 3 points about how Apple Branch operates as dystopian fiction. All right? Well done. Thanks, folks.